Learn how to create a highly available Kubernetes cluster with availability zones in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. When you create an Azure Kubernetes Service or AKS cluster in Azure, its nodes and storage all reside in the same data center. The cluster is protected from hardware failure and maintenance within the data center because the nodes and storage are distributed across fault and update domains. But this doesn't help if the data center goes down. This almost never happens, but you might still want to protect against it. You can do that by using availability zones for your Kubernetes cluster. Availability zones are unique physical locations that contain one or more data centers. And when you use them with AKS, your nodes will be distributed across the availability zones. This makes AKS highly available, as it will still run if one or even more data centers fail. Let's create a Kubernetes cluster that uses availability zones. This is the Azure Cloud Shell. You can reach it by going to shell.azure.com, and it contains the latest version of the Azure CLI. Let's use it to create a Kubernetes cluster. First, I'll create a new resource group that we'll use for the Kubernetes cluster. Alright, that's done. And now I'll create the Kubernetes cluster with this command. The node zones parameter is what will distribute the nodes across availability zones. If you don't add this parameter, the cluster will be created in one data center. Okay, let's do it. This will take a while, so I'll skip ahead to when it is done. And here it is. The Kubernetes cluster is created, and its nodes are distributed across availability zones. There you go. When you use availability zones for your Kubernetes cluster, you can make it highly available and protect it against failure of a single data center. Go and check it out.